Hello and welcome to the 19th video of my Left 4 Dead 2 mapping tutorial series. This video will be going over using your campaign maps for survival, like the default maps do. Also known as multi-gamemode support, creating a map capable of running multiple game modes is a great way to make your add-on feel more complete. If you're making a campaign, you may as well utilize some of your existing gameplay arenas throughout the campaign to easily and quickly create some survival maps. Plus, any changes you make on the map will apply to both game modes, which allows for ease of editing and improves file size efficiency. All the default maps do this. The rooftop in No Mercy is repurposed as a survival map, and a fun one at that. In order to make multi-gamemode maps, we need to utilize an entity called info_gamemode. It has outputs that fire when the map is loaded on a specific gamemode, which is what we'll be using to load in the survival entities only when the map is played in survival mode. Here's a good arena in one of my maps that can easily be translated into a survival map. It's a holdout event arena, where the survivors press the button to open a door, but the event button fires outputs to open the door, and I don't want players leaving the survival arena. We'll need to make a brand new button that is only active in survival and is tailored to that specific mode. First, make a logic_relay entity and name it survival_relay. Make an output on trigger, target the button, via the input kill. Now make the info game mode entity and give it an output on survival post IO. Target the logic relay via the input trigger. Whenever the map is loaded in survival mode, the info game mode will trigger this logic relay entity, which can be used to add or remove anything we want specific to survival. So let's do more with this logic relay. Because the original event button will be killed when the map is loaded into survival mode, we have to make a button exclusive to survival. Make a new funk button entity and put it in front of the original event button. Give it a name and change its properties as you wish. Add a new output on pressed, target the director via the input panic event. This is all we need to start a survival game. Back over by the relay, make a point_template entity and name it survival_template. In the template key values, target the new button we made exclusively for survival. In the logic relay, make a new output on trigger, target the point template via the input for spawn. When you associate entities with a point template, they won't exist until the point template is told to spawn them. So the logic relay is triggered only when the map is loaded in survival, and the relay tells the point template to spawn whatever entities it's associated with. The result is that the new button we just made will only be present in survival mode, which is exactly what we want. Over here in the back is a potential way for the survivors to escape the survival arena. We can make a blockade with entities and associate them with a point template entity. Place some prop dynamics down that block the path, along with a funk brush textured with tools clip. Make sure to make the solidity of the funk brush always solid. Make a funk_nav_blocker brush entity, textured with tools block_los. Give them all names. In the point template key values, target the entities that are used to make that new blockade. The blockade will now only spawn in survival mode, which is what we want. Don't forget to make an output in the logic relay, shortly after the template being fired, telling the nav blocker to block nav. The typical entities we use to spawn weapons and items, weapon_spawn and weapon_item_spawn, don't work in survival mode. We have to use their dedicated spawn entities, like weapon_AK47_spawn, and weapon_pain_pills_spawn. Whenever you use these entities for the survival arena, name all of them survival_items. In the survival point template, associate survival_items in one of the template lines. Lastly, we have to place the spawn points from when the map is loaded in survival. Place down an info_survivor_position entity and open its properties. In the game mode line, type in survival. Copy and paste this entity 3 times for a total of 4. You now made spawn points. If your map has info survivor rescue entities for rescue closets, make an output in the survival logic relay to kill them, else it may cause problems. If you're making a survival arena in your campaign's finale map, and the finale uses info survivor position entities to teleport the survivors away when the outro starts, be sure to kill those as well. Compile the map and load it up. You can load the map in survival mode by using the console command map, the map's name, followed by survival. Once in, turn on Navmesh editing with nav_edit1 and z_debug1. The arena where the survival game will take place needs to be marked with the battlefield or finale attributes. Because I used a holdout event arena in my campaign for the survival map, it's already marked with battlefield. I can simply start the game and it'll work. However, if your survival arena takes place in either a gauntlet event arena or just a normal part of the map, it probably won't already be marked with battlefield or finale. Go back into Hammer, make a brush textured with tools trigger and turn it into a funk underscore nav underscore attribute underscore region entity. This is a brush entity that can be used to change the attributes of any nav area it touches while the map is running. Give it a name. In the flags, check battlefield. Scale and position it so it covers the whole arena, and make more if necessary. In the survival point template entity, target the funk nav attribute region entities in the template, so it spawns when the map is loaded in survival. Compiled and in-game shows the arena is now automatically marked. Pressing the button starts the game. When you're making the mission file for the campaign, just add a new game mode for survival, with all the maps that can support it. In the description is a link to part 16 in the series where I go over making a mission file, if you don't already know how. This concludes part 19 in my Left 4 Dead 2 mapping tutorial series. Thank you for watching.